Hello students, many of the people might be having a doubt of exactly how to fill the rows in a link parameter table. I have tried to simplify and show it with the help of animation in this particular video. So we are having a universal frame U, then we are having a base frame R, then a hand frame H and the end effector frame E here. And we have to basically find, for all the cases, we have to find what is the transformation matrix that links the end effector to U. That is what we have to generally do. And what we have studied is that we have to make the base frames or the frames that we see here, we have to make it correctly so that we are able to come up with this particular transformation matrix. So we know that we will be able to find out how R is related to U, how H is related to R, how E is related to H. And the multiplication of all of this will give me basically how E is related to the universal frame. For that, we have to just draw the frame correctly, and DH convention basically helps us to draw the frame correctly and come up with a link parameter table. So this is the frame, the same U, R, H, E frame, and how we will be able to write the link parameter table for this one can be understood by looking at a very simple example. So let's take a very simple example here. So here we are having a revolute joint J1, then a translatory joint or a prismatic joint J2. The revolute joint is having a variable of θ1, joint variable of θ1, and J2 joint is having a joint variable of D2. Now here I have not drawn the link. I have drawn the link, but I have not written what is the value here. See, this can be written as D1 or L1. Okay. And here I am going to take this as 0. I can take it as some other value. I can say that it is, let's say, 5 cm. But that will be for each and every manipulator separately. When we will do, we will have to see what is the exact measurement. But for us, let us say that for the time being, it is just D1 is equal to 0. Similarly, here also we can write what is the link of this one, what is the length from here all the way up to the end effector E, we can write. But, you know, what is the this thing? We can write, but we are not going to write it right now. For our case, we'll consider this as this distance as 0, and even this one will, for the time being, we'll consider it as 0. Okay, but anyway, as you can see, there is a movement here D2, so that D2 will come into play. Okay, now if there was some length here, let's say there was some length L2, then generally we should have taken L2 plus this D2 as the total length. Okay, but that when we will write the ring parameter table, I will once again touch upon. So next we have to, you know, write for each and every joint and the end effector, we have to draw the frame. So the first step is we generally draw the Z axis. So the Z axis for the first frame, we know that it's called as the zero frame. The base frame is called as a zero frame. So in zero frame, we are having Z naught. Why we have drawn it here? Because it's in the direction in which the axis of rotation is. So the axis of rotation is in this direction, that's why we have drawn it as Z0. Similarly, for a prismatic joint, it will be the direction in which the translatory motion is. So based on that, we'll have, for that particular joint, we will draw a frame, that is frame 1, which is having a Z axis of Z1. And the final one, here there is no joint. In the end effector, there is no joint. But we can obviously draw by keeping the direction same as Z2. Now, I am not saying that you can always take the direction, you have to take the direction same as Z1, the previous one. I am not going to say that it is very, very much required. But when you do something like this, what happens is that the link parameter table becomes very simple. Okay, now based on this, I have to draw the x-axis. Now when I have to draw the x-axis, originally I should start from x0 by first drawing what is x0. Now x0, I can actually draw it anywhere. I can draw x0 maybe here, or I can even draw x0 maybe here. Any of these I can pick. So generally what I follow is, I don't draw for the case of 0 frame first. I will first go for the next frame, that is the first frame. And then I will come back to 0 frame, and then I will go to the second frame, that is Z2 frame. So why I'm doing that? I am doing that because, see, the choice of x0 can be made later because this is not dependent upon something. Whereas what should be the direction of x1 here, that is dependent on certain rules. So if I am able to say, able to show that this is the axis of x1, then I can automatically term this direction as x0. So what will happen is that x0 and x1 already I have made parallel with that arrangement. So that's why I will first find out what is the direction of x1. For that, what I have to do, what is the rule? The rule says that if two consecutive z axes are intersecting, or as it is shown here, I have to draw for x1, I have to look at z1 and z0. If z1 and z0 are intersecting, are they intersecting? Yes, they are intersecting at this point. At this point, I will be able to make x by looking at z1 and z0 shifted. How? See, I have shifted z0 here, and now z1 and z0 form a plane, and x direction of the first frame, that is x1, can be normal to this plane. So based on that rule, that is the rule we have written in DH. So based on that rule, I will draw the x1 axis to point in this direction. Now I can point it inside the page also. I can point x1 to be inside the screen also, but I have just chosen it to be in this side. Okay, so as you can see, x1 is normal to z1 and z0. Why I have done that? Because here z1 and z0 are intersecting at a point. Okay, if they would not have been intersecting at a point, I would have followed a different rule in DH. Anyway, so next I have found out x1. Then the good thing is, or the next thing that I can do is, I can find out what is x0 for the z0. So the rule says that for the base frame, if you are not able to fix which is the direction of x0, the best is to try to repeat the direction of x1, so that both of them are in parallel and you don't have to worry much about the link parameter table. The link parameter table values will have 0 if we make it parallel. So I choose x0 to be in the same direction as x1. So now the frame x0, z0 is over, x1, z1 is over. Next, I have to look what is the direction of x2, that is of frame 2. I have drawn the direction in this manner. Why? Because here z1 and z2 can be said to be in parallel. Now if they are in parallel, you can always you can draw the direction of x2 anywhere perpendicular to both z1 and z2. But here I have chosen x2 to be in this direction because here it is parallel with x1. So again, as I said previously, if your x-axis of consecutive frames are parallel to each other, the link parameter table becomes much easier to write. That's why I have chosen the x2 direction here. Otherwise, there is another possibility that I could have drawn. That direction would have been, I could have drawn x2 here. If I would have but drawn x2 there, the problem that happens is that when I will do the link parameter table, I will have to account for turning this x1 90 degrees so that it becomes x2. So to avoid that, I have drawn x2 in the same direction as x1. Okay, here, because we have followed the DH parameter rule. Now based on this, we can draw the y-axis. Now y-axis is x, y, z, right hand rule or the anti-clockwise rule. That is what I had already always said. So if you remember, if you know what is direction of x, you draw y in such a way that the anti-clockwise rule is maintained. So here if you go in anti-clockwise, automatically y will come here. Okay, otherwise people will think that okay, let me draw y here. No, y will not, because x, then comes z, then comes y not here. In that case, you will be not having this direction. You will say that x, y, z, that will be clockwise direction. So we cannot follow that. That's why we have made it into y not in this direction. Similarly here, x in the second, in the first frame, that means x1, y1, z1, I will have the y1 pointing down. So it is right hand frame again. Similarly here also, I will point. Now with this steps, I have made all the frames. So the frames are completely done. Now what I have to do is, I have to find the link parameter table for it. So I will name the frames. So the base frame is called as frame 0. The first frame is the one which has x1, y1, z1. Now what I have not written here is, I have not written the origin. So this will be origin of 0th frame. This will be the origin of first frame. This will be the origin of second frame. But I am not written here because that is not mostly coming in the vocabulary of BH. So that's why I have not written. That is the only reason. So now all the frames are done. Now based on that, I have to make a link parameter table. Now whether it's a revolute joint, whether it's a translatory, all these things are going to not come into play now. So I will slowly take them out of the picture. So now what I am having is, I am having the frames, frame 0, frame 1, frame 2, and I am having the joint variable theta 1. So joint 1 is having a joint variable theta 1. That means joint 1 will have a motion of theta 1. Similarly, joint 2 will have a joint variable of d2. So that is what is remaining. So next we take off the y-axis. Why I take off the y-axis? Why can't I keep the y-axis? See, there is no special point in keeping the y-axis because it only clutters the image. Okay, it will become very, it will look very complicated. We can do without y-axis because the DH parameter or the DH representation does not require anything to be done for the case of y. Because if we are taking care of the fact that x and z are parallel, then y-axis will automatically be parallel. So we don't have to worry about that. That's why I will take out the y-axis. So we have to look for the frames, frame 0, frame 1, frame 2. So how to go from frame 0 to frame 1? That is what we actually write in the link parameter table. So link parameter table, we have to know how to go from frame 0 to frame 1. When we have to go from frame 0 to frame 1, what we mean is we have to make x0 parallel to x1 here. Similarly, z0 travel all the way from here, all the way from here, and become parallel to z1, so that x0, z0 become parallel to x1, z1. That is when we say that we are going from frame 0 to frame 1. And for taking that, we are having four movements, and those four movements are based on theta I, di, ai, and alpha I, which are known as the link parameters. Okay, now based on that, first let us see how do we write for the case of theta I. So first we have to write about I for going from 0 to frame 1, we will call I as 1. And for that, what is theta I? Theta I is, don't mistake it with theta 1 that is drawn here. We should not mistake it with theta 1 because, you know, theta 1 is the joint variable. This is the joint variable. And this one theta I is what angle we should rotate with respect to z0. What is the angle we have to rotate? That means I take hold of z0 and I have to rotate x0 in such a way that, you know, let me select. Okay, so how do I, you know, rotate z x 0 in such a way that it becomes parallel to x 1. Now x 1 is already parallel, x 0 is already parallel to x 1. So actually we did not do any rotation. That's why I said, for making the link parameter table simple, I drew x 0 parallel to x 1 so that theta 1 becomes 0. Theta I becomes 0. So the theta I is with respect to z naught, what is the angle to be moved so that the x frame of frame 0 becomes same as the x frame or parallel as x1 of frame 1. Here it is actually 0. So I can write a 0 here. In theta I can write 0. In that row, I can write the answer as 0, but here I am having a joint variable theta I. So what I will write it as is 0 plus theta I. So in a way, I have to write here 0 plus theta I, but since I don't write 0, I can straight away write it, not theta I, sorry, 0 plus theta 1 I can write, but this 0 is why? Because x0, x1 are already parallel. Theta 1 is y because theta 1 is the direction in which this joint is going to move. So I can write this here, but there is no need to write 0. So I can write 0 plus theta 1 here for I is equal to 1. So after writing that, I will get it in this form. Now why I have written it as star here? I have put it as star here, theta 1 star, because that is a variable. That means it is changing value. Okay. Next, I have to see. So x0 is parallel to x1. Next, I have to see what is di. Di is the distance that has to be traveled along zi minus 1 axis to make xi minus 1 collinear to xi. Now what is I here? I is 1. So let me reread the sentence. The sentence will be, distance to be translated along the z0 axis, distance to be traveled along z0 axis to make x0 collinear to xi. What is the meaning of collinear? Collinear means being in the same line, one behind the other, or you know, on top of each other. Collinear means being in one line. So how much we have to translate this one so that, what is the translation direction? Translation direction is in z0 direction. So you can see I am moving in the z0 direction. So how much we have to translate so that I take this above and make it in such a way that x1 and x0 overlap with each other? Not overlap, collinear. Here they are overlapping, but generally what I want to make is collinear to each other. So for moving that, the distance that I will have to move is, obviously I will have to move this much distance. Now this distance, in certain cases, it might be written as some 5 centimeter or 5, but in our case I am just going to take it as 0. Okay, why? Because most of the problems, they don't specify this length, so people take this length as 0, so I am also going to take that length as 0. So I will just write here 0. If this would have been 5 centimeter, I would have written here, instead of 0, I would have written here 5. Okay. So that is the distance di. Distance di is when you move, let me again show, when you move in z0 direction, you move the whole frame so that x0 and x1 are collinear. Now collinear means actually one in the same direction, but here when we are bringing it in this particular position, both of them are overlapping. So anyway, so that is what the distance di, or for our case d1, is. So d1 is 0 and my frame has reached there. Now you can see that x0, x1 are already overlapped. Now the next is, what is ai distance? So what is ai distance? Ai distance is the distance that has to be translated along the xi minus 1 axis to bring the origins of both the frames together. Sorry, here I should have written, there is a mistake here, I should have written xi minus 1 and xi together. Okay, so that's a mistake. So I am trying to bring both of them together. Actually here both of them are already together. If they would have been collinear, if they would have been collinear, that means if this would have been little bit back, so let me, you know, try to show that. If this would have been somewhere here, then how much distance I have to move in x direction so that both of these overlap. Right now here the distance is 0. So I will write ai as 0. Now only thing that is left is I have to make z0 parallel with z1. For that I have to turn z0 and make it in the direction of x1. So that is the last alpha, that is the twist. It is called as the link twist. So what is the link twist that I have to give? So what is alpha I or link twist? It is the angle at which the zi minus 1 is to be rotated. Zi minus 1, here I is equal to 1. So z0 axis has to be rotated about x1 axis. So I am looking at x1 axis. Okay. So x1 axis is already here. So based on x1 axis, I have to rotate this and try to make it. So how much I am rotating and in which direction I am rotating with respect to x. As you can see, with respect to x1 axis, this is going to rotate in which direction? It is rotating in clockwise direction. And it has to rotate 90 degrees so that it becomes parallel to z1. So I am going to go in clockwise direction. So this is clockwise direction and this is anti-clockwise direction with respect to frame, not frame, axis x1. Okay, we have to look at the xi axis, so x1 axis. So with respect to x1, this direction is clockwise. So I have to move in that direction how much angle? So clockwise means we know that it is negative angle. And how much is the angle? 90 degree. So I can say that alpha 1 is going to be 90 degree. So when I do that, you can see that x0, z0 is now parallel to x1, z1. And if I am going to draw y axis, y of both the y0 and y1, both of them will also be parallel. So now I can say that with these four movements, I have made the frame 0 parallel to frame 1. Okay, and with that, that particular row is over. So I don't have to, I have shifted the frame. Now frame 0 has completely aligned with frame 1. With that, this particular row is over. Now with these values, I will be able to write my A1. I will be able to write what is A1 with this particular value. So that we'll look at the end. Next, so now frame 0 is out of the picture. Now the second row is frame going from frame 1 to frame 2. So again, the same theta I. So now my I is going to be 2. So let me write that I is going to be 2. Okay. And theta I. What is theta I? Theta I is to make the x-axis of the frame 1 parallel to the x-axis of frame 2. So we are moving from frame 1 to frame 2, isn't it? So we have to first make the x-axis parallel. Now it is already parallel. You remember how this is parallel? I told you that I am choosing to draw x2 in such a way that it is parallel to x1. The advantage of that is that here I can write 0. Why it is 0? Because already this is parallel. I don't have to make any movement. So this is 0. So once theta I is done, next I will have to look at di. Di is the distance that I have to translate. So if you look here, this is the distance that I have to translate. Now here, if I write here, we have to be very careful. If I write that this distance would have been L2, then the total distance I would have written L2 plus the variable, the joint variable D2. I would have written both of these values as addition here. But since L2, I am going to take in my case, in this case, I am going to take L2 as 0. What I am left it with only D2, and that is what I will, you know, right here. So D2 is the distance that I am going to move. So that is basically going to be D2 star, meaning it is a joint variable. With that, now both the frames, both of them are actually aligned. So x1 is parallel to x2, z1 is parallel to z2. So automatically there is nothing to be moved in AI, which is, you know, because already x1 and x2 are already x1 and x2 are what do you say, parallel. So this is xi. So the equation, the statement would have been the distance that is to be translated along the x0 direction, so that i is 2. So this is x1, so that x1 and x2 are together. So x1 and x2 are already here together. There is no need to move in x direction this origin. There is no need to move that direction. So here also the ai value is going to be 0. Next, what is the link twist to be given so that z1 and z2 are parallel? That is alpha I, but here already both of them are parallel, so again I will put the value 0. So with these steps I have completed the row, and with this one I have taken the frame 1, completely aligned it with frame 2, and with this step I have completed the second row of the link parameter table, and with this the whole link parameter table is completed. So what remains in the end is that I am having the frame structure with which I started, and I am having the link parameter table based on that. Now, based on this I can find out what is A1 and what is A2. So this is AI. This is AI. So I can find out what is A1 and A2 by putting these values, okay, in this matrix. This is the matrix that I have already, we have derived it for the case of DH representation. So theta, for each case you have to write what is theta, what is alpha, what is A and what is D, and with that you can write this matrix. And so finally, if somebody asks me that, what is T of frame 2, so I will write that what is T2 with respect to 0, then I can write that it is basically what is the relationship between 1 and 0 and what is the relationship between 2 and 1, and that is what is going to give me. And what is this? This is basically our A1 and A2, which we actually get it from here. So that will give us what is. Now here there may be a universal frame that is drawn somewhere, universal frame that is drawn somewhere. So this is the universal frame. So this is XU, YU, ZU. So based on that, first if I am able to find out what is the transformation to come from here to here based on the similar rule, just like this, if I am going to draw another row, I will be able to get what is A0. What is A0? How I bring from the universal frame to the base frame? But generally that is not done here. Anyway, so the same way I can, draw the universal frame somewhere, and I can multiply that relation of the base frame with the universal frame so that I get what is the link between the frame 2 and the universal frame. I will totally get it by just multiplying this one. What is this one? This is A0. This is A0. A0 is what is your transformation matrix of U relating to, zero relating to U. So this is how we fill a link parameter table and get the transformation matrix. Thank you.